I am a mountain, I am a tall tree. Oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river. I am the
life is sweet when you're ready to take the bold step. And how do you take this bold step? Is by killing the fear in you. It is better to try to fail than fail to try. Good evening and welcome to your best show, The Boldest. It's still your babe, Esther Shine, your light in shining armor, your sweet babe. With you tonight also are my heroes, your heroes. They are to take up the show tonight. In fact, this night I'm going to give you outdoor events. You understand what I mean? So please do not touch that dial. Don't leave your television set. Stick on it. Stay on it. No, go nowhere. We'll be right back.
Ram on the dawn of Nollywood. I'm here to tell you to keep watching the boldness.
I want to introduce a very talented person, a hero, a bold person, and also a very young entrepreneur. We have a lot to learn from this guy. Please go nowhere. Let's go and see how whatever he has for us will help our life.
So based on what I saw in your office, I won't call that shop. What I saw actually attracted me, so I took the shot. Let's see the shot.
Wow.
So that is, I want them to meet you. Tell us about yourself and how you got to this stage.
Okay. Yeah. My name is Chukwudi Okoro.
Okay.
I'm from Abia State.
Okay.
Now to put it under the next. By grace, I'm the last child of from my parents.
How many are they?
We are four in number.
Wow.
So I'm the last.
Wow.
Two girls, two boys.
Mm.
So I started this work in 2012.
Okay.
When I finished my secondary school, it was not easy for my parents. The other ones are in university, so they couldn't afford the money for me to be there. So by this grace, I love creative, to create something.
Okay.
I love to create something with my hands. So when my brother asked me, would you like to learn work, I said yes. Though initially I have something in mind,
okay,
not this furniture, but thank God I found something similar to what I want.
Okay, what was that?
It was POP, ceiling POP, this modern POP.
Okay.
Yeah, I love that work so much because it's creative.
Yeah.
You create different design.
Yes.
Yes. So okay, when you say this furniture, I say furniture.
Okay,
I like furniture because it's also creative.
Okay.
So he said, okay, come to Asaba. I came to Asaba, he introduced me to my master. So my master now said that I will, then I was 19.
Okay.
I was 19. Okay. So he now said I will learn the work for 3 years for me to be perfect.
Okay.
And I will serve him for 2 years.
Wow.
So the years was too much. When I think
too
of,
much, oh, if you see my man, then wow.
When I think of 5 years, I say God.
Wow, long journey.
It is big, but the only thing that I picked up was courage.
Hmm.
You know, in life, anything that have beginning, have ending.
Yeah.
So one day,
it
will end.
Yeah.
So I started learning the work. It was not easy. It was not easy for me. Many started with two, but they couldn't make it.
Okay.
Many run because of hardship. But with courage and by the grace of God, I was able to conquer.
Okay. You liked to go further in your education, but because of the situation at that time in the family, you decided to go into skill, or you had wanted to be a skillful man?
Yeah, there are some people now, they went to school and they still have company where they produce different kinds of things,
of
you understand?
Course,
which means they love to create.
Of course.
They don't want to sit down at home to answer boss. So I love creation to create, and I also love to further my education.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So that means if you further your education, if you have an opportunity to work in an office,
would you still want to work in an office and be running your business, or you just want to get focused 100% on this business?
Yeah, if I further my education, I'll be working on my office. I'll also be working on my business. You know why?
Why?
Because office work, none of your children can inherit office work, but your business, your children can inherit your business.
Wow.
And you can also make name. In your office, you can't make name.
No.
They only know you in your office.
Office,
I don't know you, but other people know you through your business. You understand?
I like this point. This one never came to me. I have been talking, speaking English on this program, but I never saw the other side of it. Hey! So this one on a secret. Everybody want name. Wow. So Oyibo would rather make name than getting the money from the office. No wonder they everyday invest. Every day Oyibo man they invest. Wow, this is a very good idea. You want to make your name, despite the fact that you might be working in an office in the future. So what have been the challenge, or what are the challenges surrounding this business?
Nothing good comes easy.
Okay.
I understand. So there are many challenges. Like I said before, from in the beginning, and when I started the work, it was not easy.
The impression I have gotten from what I saw means that you're out of this world. The truth is, those things were like something they built elsewhere, maybe from what do they call it, America or whatever, where they built furniture, get country where they know where they build country. So they brought them down to your shop and display. But not until I walked fast and I saw the action. I knew when the raw materials came. I saw when they offloaded the woods and the foams. But in the next few hours again, the wood and the foam became another thing entirely. You understand?
Yeah.
So, what are the challenges behind or challenges in this your business? Because there must be challenge, ongoing challenge you face. Could it be morphine? You need more finance? Could it be unfavorable weather? Could it be customers' attitude? And I'll mention are the challenges you face in your business.
The only challenge I face in my business right now is financial status.
Okay.
Yeah. If I can be, because I'm just starting, understand? So if I can be able to have enough as I want, that's not my dream. My dream is to be more bigger than legend.
Oh, I like the dream. If you don't want to stop here, so which one you want me to be like? Because what do you mean? Be like, I don't understand.
No.
What do you
mean?
Don't be like, what is the dream for this country? No. You be like, what is the dream for all those executive furniture shop? What is the dream? So if you feel that this one is too small, you want to aim higher, like you want to construct and make something better, I still wonder what could be better than what you have done.
That's what I'm saying. That's just the beginning.
Wow. That's just the beginning. So let me take you back to some of his work. Like this one that is showing on the screen.
Yeah.
I saw some buttons from Javier. I saw something that looks like television. I wouldn't know. So please, can you throw a light on what we use in designing?
Okay.
Design.
Alright. The bed is a 6x6 bed, and it have so by the left. If you look at it, it have two lights, and there is something that in front of the bed. It look like screen.
Okay.
Yeah, but actually it's screen and glass. Okay. But that two light is controlled by remote.
Okay.
Then the other one by the right side. Some people actually look at it as speaker. When they come, they say, ah, is this speaker? I say, no, it's not speaker, it's light. When you look under, you will see the light. Then there is a switch behind the bedside, that drawer. Then there is a control switch there. That's the switch that controls the light. Why the other one is controlled by the wind? Understand? So that's it. While the other chair is, I can call it king chair. I am a king,
the boldest. I want to sit on that seat.
Yeah, so that one is, you can call it king, queen, anyone. So it's made of food.
Okay.
After the magic.
Real magic.
Like you said, it's magic. After everything, now came out to the final product.
Yes.
Yes. Those things you're seeing there is button. You know? That button, we have different type of button. We have the white one, black, gold, and different colors. Mm-hmm. And we also have the fake one.
Ah, in every industry, we have fake one.
Yeah, they also have the fake one, but we started from the beginning. Where my master, he took me to market. Mm-hmm. He showed me this one is the one you buy for me.
Okay.
If you mistakenly buy the wrong one, you return it. You return it and buy it. Even though the money is not complete again, you return it and buy the new one. Because this is not what he told you to buy initially. So that's it.
This is very, very interesting. And I hope you are seeing what I am seeing. The one way they speak English today, I hope you saw what I saw. Seriously, he has been doing a great job. And if you are out there thinking that these things you saw were catalogs from abroad, you might be making a very big mistake. Wow, Chuks, it's been wonderful speaking with you this evening. I thank you for making up time to come on your show, despite the fact that I'm taking more of your time. And you out there, you need to patronize somebody like this. This one will be small, okay? This one is big, okay? Forget the past, say no, get the belly. This one now, guy, when you call a guy, go answer. He was trained from a very good background, just like what he said, that his boss wouldn't allow him to get anything fake. They would rather go for the superior one. You know, so it was a wonderful orientation that he has continued. Because some people say, this kind of thing they find, you know, they're strong. They're like, come on, try it, if it's strong. So once again, thank you so much. I want you to review your address. Tell us where they can meet you. If you have a phone number, a business phone number, you will need so that you can run it on our school.
For your more inquiries for anything furniture, you can call me on 081-32-47-3849. You can also WhatsApp me on the same number. Okay.
So where is your business address? You want to come and see?
Okay, it's located at the Apple Junction, before New Hospital Road, along that New Hospital Road, then you see my sample Chuks interior.
But before you go, I have something for you that is what makes you a hero. Because the only people that come to my program are heroes in their own way. Now you just told me you started, but I hope too that you will want to train people. You have people that you're training already.
Yes, but, I have two boys.
Okay,
yeah.
That you're training right now.
Yeah.
So in case you still want to learn from him, please do contact him. Thank you so much. Chuks. So this is what we have for Chuks. I hope you can read. This is written, the boldest. Chuks is a bold hero. 5 years, maybe 5 naira. 5 years, maybe 5 days. 5 years. Took him 5 years to learn what he just showed you and more than he has for you. So truth, you deserve it. This is from us, the brother. So please, can you put this on your head? Let's see it on your head.
Thank you. Thank you very
much. You know, you need to take a girl that is so annoying that day. You can wear the cap and nothing will harm you. Correct. I'm a vendor. What is this? Yeah. Correct.
Okay.
So this kind of one, you enter soil, but they walk and tie, some go. You know, shine. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed what you saw. Those things, those birds, those TV set, those things we saw, they were just out of this world. I never believed those things were made in Nigeria until I got to know his shop. And when I got to his shop, I saw the raw material and the finished material. That is talent for you. He is a bold guy. He is a hero. And you out there that you don't even know what to do, or you want to do, you've not found the right place to learn, please do keep in touch with Mr. Chuks, and he will also train you the way he was trained. The next person we are going to give you also will shock you. Like I said, tonight is going to be shock, hot. She is a very young lady. You'll be surprised to hear all you will hear. She is a producer, a manager, a script writer, an editor, an actress, in fact, in short, she's just everything. Please join me. Let's go and meet this pretty lady.
Today, now, waka day. But the waka day pays. It pays a lot. And if you
carry one back. Then not one back. Can't put it in the back. Now office baby back. The first day I met her, I was wondering, no, I don't understand. The person tell me go meet her. Anyway, you go understand, like, let me not talk so much. She's going to introduce herself properly. Then I will tell you the story behind the production. Please join me and welcome this damsel. Fine girl. Welcome to the show, Yifli.
Thank you very much.
I am so happy that you agreed to sit down here with me and answer some of the questions.
You are boldest
now. I don't want to know. Thank you so much for your understanding. So please, we want to meet you. Let's know if you tell us everything about yourself.
My name is Nzemezie Ifeanyi Glory.
Okay.
A graduate of biochemistry in State University. And one big brother and one big sister. Okay. Last out of three. I'm an editor, a video editor.
Okay.
An actor and a writer. I'm from Enugu State, born and brought up in Delta State.
So, my dear Ifi, for how long have you been into this business of editing, video editing, and the other stuff?
2015, I was supposed to serve.
Okay.
But before I got my call up later, I turned on a friend who is an editor.
Okay.
So, with going there to keep them company, just to watch them do the job, because as at then I was already acting.
Okay.
We started acting as at 2014.
Wow.
Late 2014. So I did a short movie. I started producing actually.
Mm-hmm.
My parents were against me acting. So I thought of what to do. I wrote a story. My parents saw it and they were like, you're good. Still, they refused to allow me join the industry because of the stories they hear. So, I was lucky I met a family friend who was good at covering ceremonies, and also he shot some Christian movies. So, in contact, he said, if he helped me. So, he shot the story for me, just with family and friends, we just gather. You know, this kind of people, we don't know that shoots it, stuff like that.
Yeah, the magic.
Luckily for me, came out fine, and then I took it to Electromax where movies are being sold, and I got to market and I agreed to market the film. So when income comes in, he can do the continuation of the film. He now asked me to get the locations I used, and because I was born and brought up in Ibuzo, it was very easy for me, and my mom was very popular in the church. So almost every house I enter will know me. Ah, come on, come that. And they'll be like, oh yeah, yeah, come shoot.
Okay.
So that was how I started. I was now doing location manager.
Okay.
From doing location manager, they were like, you write, then write a story for me. I can't become script writer. With that, I now started acting. One scene, two scene, just walk pass, and all that. But then, the little I got, I was able to show my talent as much as I can. And it's always recorded in their head, man, this game is cool. You understand? And then from there, I shot a short movie that I put on YouTube. During the editing of that movie, the editors come, they slow because they get workload.
Yeah.
And when they go studio, they go keep them company. Just to ginger them. You know, see, when you know the person complete one,
you want this
one, you do one kind of two delay to show you say them they're relevant.
Yeah.
So I was always going there. When they will see my face very, very sad, they will now want to help me lose the job. But that period of time, that was when I lost the job. They saw the zeal in me and they were like, do you know you can learn this thing? And with that, I started going there constantly.
Mm-hmm.
I did not pay any dime. I was lucky. All thanks to Dube and Victor. I ran grateful to him.
Dube, I was in there.
Yes, that big studio. That was the name of the studio I learned from that editing job.
In
Asaba. Asaba, yes, Bonsa.
Wow.
So he taught me. He was like, two things. Before you know, I started becoming perfect in the job.
Yeah.
Until I lost my dad. And I had to stay with my mom for some time. I lost the house, stay with her during her mourning period. So then I opened a take my laptop. That was when I started carrying the school bag before you mocked me. So I would carry my laptop to the studio. If he has a job for me, he will just copy it into the laptop. I'll go home and do it and bring it back to me. So that was how I started.
Wow, if he, I am impressed. See, do you know why I feel this way?
Wow.
I feel this way when I see young people bringing out, you know, the force, the gift in them, not whiling away their time, wasting time looking for already made money from someone else you want to extort. See, the first day I met her, seriously, somebody directed me to her to edit a job for me. It was an emergency. The impression I got when I saw this small girl, me hammer, I think maybe that's a small sister. She can't carry me, maybe go make her go see the person. Ah, she said that she, before not have a dumbbell laptop. Hey! I said, Jesus, Jesus. Ask her, I told her, you must teach me. This is challenge. So, well, if you now takes me to one of the challenges, I think, maybe you will educate me more. The challenges of gender. You are a lady, it is not common. We have so many editors around. And since when I grew up, not only boys and men, now they do this kind of movie editing and that. So please, have you ever encountered any challenge, like gender challenge?
Yes.
Because of your gender?
I have. Sometimes I get a job and the person will be like, ah, this is a big job. You're calling a girl a female editor. I don't believe in female editors. Yes, that is always their statement. But it doesn't shake me. Like, I don't feel anything because I know I will just cut one scene and you'll be like, excuse me?
Who did this one? I'm not getting
it. So, when they try to sideline me or make me feel less of myself, I'll just be laughing. I'll just be, one day, you will still come running back to me. Women are very stronger than men. It depends on, do you really believe it? If you believe it, you will see yourself in good places. I don't see any reason why I would say I cannot be an editor. Ah, it's men's work. Ah, God creates men, right? I'm an editor.
God ahead, my dear me husband. That is wonderful. God no create my parents. Only man. Even when they constitute yourself, no only man will be
editor.
Try. Because I did their feelings. They didn't want to do fair.
I just wait until you make it. When I'll be ready for you, maybe what did I go to you? Maybe what did I go to you? Even if you think you'll be anything, you'll be rich, but whatever it is, I go reduce you. You know, so the ball, you won't have touch you.
You are not watching and enjoying the fine fit. You are watching, you are listening. and you are getting something from the Boldest show.
What I have here is written, the boldest.
Wow.
It is only the bold that takes the bold step. Those ones where no one fail, what we call their failure. This is the boldest. You deserve this. This represents who you are. So if they see them for your head, like you carry down your bag, that
I know you're trying to wait for you. You see, you have for head. You have issues with my bag.
The sun was actually high that day, you know. She hands the bag. So this carpet, when you put up your head under the sun, in the rain, you're moving ahead. So it's my pleasure, if you to hand this
wait.
Over to
I
you. Put it on your head. Let's see. Ah, oh my God, this is beautiful. You are indeed the boldest. You are indeed.
Thank you very much.
I've never seen anything. Wow, this is nice. Thank you for coming on the show. And I hope you were shocked when you saw that pretty small lady. I hope so, because in this part of the world, we would think, I too small. Time still day. Time not day. Time not day. Time not just day. So I don't know how old you are, but it doesn't matter your age. Ify is ready for you. Thank you, Ify. Thank you, Chooks, for coming on my program. Thank you, my lovely audience, for sticking on me. Thank you for believing in me. And also thank you in advance, for I know you'll be with me next week right here in this station at the same time. Please do not forget to follow us on our social media handles, like the one scrolling on your screen, the Facebook, the Instagram, YouTube, and all of them. We're there everywhere. Anywhere where you press, just mention Peace Media, the Boldest, you go appear. We'll be there. If you missed any of our episode, please go back to the YouTube. That is where you get the full video. And also, if you are skilled out there, you have your own business, you have something to show to the world, please do not hesitate to dial my number, and I will be right there to answer you and to bring you out for the people to see and know. Till next week, same time, same station, I will say, this is where we draw the curtain, and I'm going to sign out as your babe, as usual, Esther Stein. Do have a lovely night's rest.
Look them in the face and say,